School standards. School attention.
Freedom in the mind, faith in the words, pride in our souls. Let's salute the nation on this Independence Day. Good morning, everyone.
Today, we all of us have gathered here to celebrate a very special occasion, the Independence Day of our country.
Yes, on this day, we remember the sacrifices of our freedom fighters and celebrate the freedom they have brought to us. I, Lahari from class 10th, and
I, Nelson from class 10th, we extend a warm welcome to you all on this very special and memorable day in the history of India. Let us dedicate this Independence Day to all the martyrs who have given their lives for the great nation.
Let's begin our celebrations. We shall put our hands together to welcome all our dignitaries with the school band. We have amidst us Reverend Father Sylvester DeCosta, President of today's program, Chief Guest, Mr. Jeet Roach, St. Anne Church Parish Council Vice President, Mr. Santosh DeCosta, Secretary, Mrs. Celine DiMello, St. Anne Church Parish Pastoral Council elected member for the school, Mr. Harold Montero, PTA Vice President, Mr. Vinod Rego, our High School Headmaster, Mr. John Pais, and Primary Headmistress, Mrs. Irene Menezes. May I request our school SPL, Master Sohan Joshua, to escort the guests to the dais.
Occasion, we have a lineup of events that will remind us the significance of this day and our love for our motherland. Let us begin with flag hoisting ceremony where we will witness the unfurling of our national flag. I kindly request our honorable chief guest along with other dignitaries to come forward to hoist the national flag. I call upon our SPL to lead the dignitaries to hoist the national flag.
Sir, as we celebrate 70th Independence Day of our country, may I kindly request you to come over and unfurl the national flag.
Parade, salute!
Chenna Ganna Mata Hari Ma.
officers, kindly take your seats.
Parade, left about, turn!
Marching involves marching step with others and executing various commands. Here they are our comrades marching led by our school band.
March!
fast.
Parade about town!
As light expels darkness, a solemn prayer casts away our fears, calms our souls, and fills us with strength and positivity. Indeed, prayer invigorates us and guides our thoughts and actions towards harmony and goodwill. I request my friends to lead us with the prayer dance.
Thank you.
our honorable headmaster, Mr. John Pass, to welcome the gathering.
In 1916, Bal Gangadhar Tilak wrote, "Freedom is my birthright, and I shall have it." On 14th August 1947, at midnight hour, Nehru said, "Christ with destiny." And today, all of us are proudly saying, "Mera Bharat Mahan." Honorable correspondent, chief guest, and all the dignitaries on the dais, and my dear proud citizens of our country. As the whole nation commemorates and celebrates its 78th Independence Day, we have come together to pay respect and homage to our great nation. A very good morning and welcome to you all for this celebration. At the very outset, I would like to welcome our correspondent, Reverend Father Sylvester DeCosta, the president of this program. On behalf of everyone gathered here, I extend a hearty welcome to you, dear Father. May I kindly request Mrs. Hemavati, the senior teacher, to give him floral welcome. Thank you, ma'am. Our brave soldiers are guarding our borders. But here we have a dedicated and committed son of the Mother Earth. He is Mr. Jeet Roach, today's chief guest. Let me introduce him to you all. Protect the Mother Earth and she will protect you. Mr. Roach, a native of Kashmir, Jaipur, Mangalore, is a well-known environmentalist and a social worker. His passion towards the environment goes back to 2004, at the worst phase of his life, when he planted 25 saplings. This humble journey continued ever since, and with the able guidance and support from the regional forest officer, Mr. Clifford Lobo, he has planted more than 4,000 saplings in the cemeteries and burial grounds in and around Mangalore. In 2012, the stretch of 13 kilometers of National Highway 75 between Marode and Porangipet and the stretch of NH-66 between Nantur and Panambur saw more than 15,000 saplings planted, including Miyawaki Forest at Padwa, Padil, Nandigudan, Surathkal and elsewhere. A Vriksha Premi, he is the founder of Vana Charitable Trust in 2022, and with his volunteers, he has planted about 10,000 saplings in the Western Ghats and hence crossed the landmark of 2,20,000 saplings all together. Let us give him a big hand. Mr. Roach not just plants the saplings, which every one of us do. He ensures that they are taken care of. He does everything in his capacity to make a cleaner planet to live in for all of us. He has organized several cleanliness drives in the district, along with the government, local bodies, education institutions, and other organizations. The two lifeline rivers of Dakshina Kannada, Netravati and Falguni, are being cleaned periodically from the life-threatening garbage and plastic trash. At a time when the mighty trees are being felled mercilessly in the name of urbanization and development, he has successfully transplanted more than 70 trees. As a part of waste management, he has set up composting units at several well-known institutions, including St. Aloysius College, Yenagoya College, and Father Muller's Hospitals, to name a few. As another step to conserve the environment, along with Mr. Louis Pinto, he has set up a cloth bank which collects and distributes clothes to the needy under two initiatives like one for my sister and one for my brother. For all his dedication and commitment for the cause of Mother Nature, he has been conferred with a long list of awards and honors at the state and national level, such as Aranya Mitra, Pollution Control Award, Infant Jesus Man of the Year Award for the family, AICU Centenary Award, to name a few. We are indeed honored to have you as the chief guest for this program. Your noble mission may serve as an inspiration to many in the sacred task of protecting and preserving the environment. On behalf of everyone present here, I extend a cordial welcome to you, sir. I kindly request our correspondent to offer a bouquet and welcome Mr. Roach and his trust. Let's applaud. With immense pleasure, I would like to welcome Madam Sheila. With immense pleasure, we welcome Mr. Santosh DiCosta, the Vice President of our Parish Pastoral Parishad, Mr. Celine DiMello, the Secretary, Mr. Harold Montero, the nominated member from the Parish Parishad, Mr. John Vinod Rego, the Vice President of the PTA, and other members of the Management Committee. Welcome you all to this program. I request Mrs. Eileen Menezes to offer them a floral welcome. We also take great pleasure to welcome all our parishioners, PTA Executive Committee members, our esteemed parents, our benefactors, as well as our well-wishers. A hearty welcome to you all. A present welcome to Mrs. Eileen Menezes, the primary section headmistress, all the staff members, both teaching and non-teaching, who have designed and executed this program. A hearty welcome to you all. Last but not the least, our dear students, you are the ones who have made this celebration possible through your interest, hard work and commitment. I'm sure that you are going to make everyone happy here by your disciplined performance. A warm welcome and all the best to you. Once again, a hearty welcome to one and all. Jai Hind.
Welcome you too.
Saffron, white and green are those three colors that thrills every Indian and binds the entire nation together. It is indeed a proud feeling to see our tricolor flutters freely in the air. I call upon Rayola to explain the significance of the day. Over to you, Rayola.
Good morning to you all. Respected correspondent, honorable chief guest, guest of honor, headmaster, teachers, parents, parishioners and my dear friends. It is indeed a great day for all of us. Day to celebrate and rejoice as we have gathered here as the children of one mother, our dear revered Mother India, to celebrate 78 years of freedom. Freedom, that word sounds to be so simple. However, it has a great significance and values. A value which can be understood only when it is lost. If we are able to enjoy this freedom, it is only because of the great sacrifice made by the scores of freedom fighters for more than a century. It is time that we remember all those martyrs and pay respect and homage to them. Mahatma Gandhi, Lokmanya Tilak, Gopala Krishna Gokhale, Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, Vallabhbhai Patel and others have successfully led the nation towards freedom and liberated this country from the slavery of the British. Any anniversary should be an occasion for introspection. It is time that we look back for a while to
see how far we have reached over these 77 years. Yes, we have definitely come a long way, making great progress in industry, agriculture, trade, science, technology, education, etc. The course is continuing. We are very proud of it. However, there are areas of concern. It is also the time to ask ourselves whether we are really enjoying this freedom. A gloom of fear, uncertainty, communal hatred, corruption, etc. Religious fundamentalism giving way to heinous crimes which are taking place on our daily basis. Political morality has been banished, freedom of speech has been restricted. Which makes one to ask, is this freedom our ancestors have fought for? Definitely not. Then what shall we do? As tomorrow's citizens of our dear Mother India, it is our duty to protect and preserve the freedom that we had inherited. We should develop broad-mindedness and promote mutual respect, tolerance and understanding with our fellow beings, and work with dedication and commitment to make the dream of our freedom fighter to be a strong and a peaceful nation, a reality, a true tribute to all of them. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Mayula.
Dance is the loveliest of all the arts because it gives us the slightest excuse to feel and be completely beautiful. Now we are going to witness a beautiful and lovely group dance performance.
Oh,
Wow, what a wonderful performance. Thank you friends for your melodious voice.
On this glorious day, all of us take a pledge to work in unison, make our nation to become strong. Dumbbell is a full body fusion workout, incorporates dance and yoga for both cardiovascular and muscle building benefits. Lathing is a folk dance form of the state of Maharashtra. This dance carries a small musical instrument with jingling cymbal called the Lathing dance. Oops dance is one of the individual dance and it is performed as the show dance in many tribes. Here are our friends coming forward to perform physical display.
मेरा मुल्क मेरा देश मेरा निवासन शांति का पुण्य का प्यार का चमन मेरा मुल्क मेरा देश
fortunate to have an erudite and eminent personality, Mr. D. Roach, as a chief guest for today's program. I deem it my privilege and honor to invite the honorable chief guest to address the gathering.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you. Wish you all a happy Independence Day. Well, it's 78 years now that we got independence. And what I feel now is the freedom that we received have been misused a lot. The Britishers came, they robbed, they went. 78 years before, there was more than an estimated, more than 70% green cover or forest in India. So when Britishers left, they might have robbed approximately 20-25%. Present, we are left with only 21%. So who robbed the 52%? Who robbed? So you have robbed the freedom of the children. You have robbed children from giving them good air, good water, and good food. They have lost the freedom. See, I can see two groups here. One side full of adults, and another side innocent children. See, now, what I want to give the message today is, have you ever seen from where the water is coming to your tap? Elli inda bartha ide ninge neevu aa dam ige hogi nodidira? Mangalore lives more than 60% of the sewage water into the water, and the same water you are drinking and you are giving your children also. Mangalore has got just 6.2% green cover. Do you know what air you are breathing? The cancer in areas, in industrial area, is increased more than 40%. So now what type of development are we giving to our children? So if you really love your children, these three things are important. Yes, definitely, trying to give them good education, fine. But these three things are very important. Give your children good air, give your children good water, give your children good food. And all these three things are missing. With just 21% of forest cover, and to our shocking, the pristine forest, undisturbed forest, is just 3%. Now we are very busy, thinking about something else. Money, you are running behind, how to make money, your investments, insurance, all that is fine. But have you thought of investing in nature for your children so that they can breathe good air? See, we don't have choice. If you are living in places like Baikal Party, you have to breathe that polluted air. See, nobody has ever bothered to ask the administration how much cancer is increased in Mangalore. There was only one cancer hospital, now we have five. So is that development? So my humble request to the parents and the parishioners, yes, and the teachers, other than giving them good road, good education, let's give them the basic of giving them good air, good water, and good food. I really feel pity for the children. They have nothing left. The forest has been robbed. The mining is robbed. The sand is robbed. All that natural resources, what was supposed to be given to our children, is all robbed. If you don't wake up now, then it's going to be a tough time. The Wayanad type incident will definitely happen in Agumbe, in Western Ghats. It is systematically robbed. Nobody is even bothering to ask is this road necessary? Why this huge roads in between the Western Ghats, in between the reserve forest? How will the animals cross? You might think this year we have some good rains and we will have no problem for water. Trust me, by January there will be a lot of shortage of water. No forest, no rain. This time there is rain, floods, everything, but there is no forest, it will not give us water. There will not be streams left. So, if you really love your children, let's try to work hard. Let's try to, put in a lot of efforts to invest in nature. Let's improve the brain power. If Indira Gandhi had not bought that Forest Act in 1980, there would have been absolutely no forest. I don't know how that thing came to our mind. Some of the national parks, if it is there in India, the credit should go to Indira Gandhi. So well, on this day, I once again wish you a happy Independence Day. Let us give more freedom to our children so that they breathe good air, drink good water, and eat good food. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your thoughtful and inspiring message.
Dance is the most beautiful form of expression of human feelings. Dancers are the messengers of God. Let's pay our homage to our glorious motherland through a patriotic dance.
A fabulous performance.
The theatrical technique of expressing an idea or mood portraying a character entirely by a gesture and body movements without the use of words. Now, our friends are going to perform a mime show about the soldiers who have fought for our country.
Thank you.
Fernandez, our correspondent, Reverend Father Silvestre de Costa, the president of today's program, is on set to deliver his message. Over to you, Father.
Good morning, everybody. Today's chief guest, Mr. Jeff Miller Roach, one of the guests of the dais, all my friends. This is the 78th Independence Day celebration. First and foremost, I congratulate all the children of our school for their greatest performance. Give them a big hand. I wish every one of you the good wishes, with the good wishes of our Independence Day. 77 years have passed, and 78th Independence Day calls us to be the guardians and the protectors of our country and the sources and resources of our country. As the chief guest has told us today, we need to be alert. We need to use our freedom in a way that helps me and everyone. As I always say, freedom is to do more work. Swatantriya namage swatantra bhumiya makkalige jaasti kelasa madlikke onda avakasha. To do more work, to do good work, and that way become the good citizens of our country. Berevarinda namage swatantra sikkide, we have become independent citizens of our country from the Britishers. But today there are many persons and many ways where we are tied down. Namage swatantra sikkidru swatantravagi jeevisadakke namage saadhya aagodilla yakandre ee naadina ee bhoomiya halavu sangathigalu nammannu katti haakta idive. We have to get freedom from all those touches, and also we have to respect the freedom of others. ನನಗೆ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಇದೆ, ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರವಾಗಿ ಜೀವಿಸಬಹುದು, ಆದರೂ ಬೇರೆಯವರ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯವನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಿಸುವಂತಹವರು ನಾವಾಗಬೇಕು. ಅಂದರೆ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರವಾಗಿ ಜೀವಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಹಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ನಮಗೆ, ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳಿಗೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಹಾಗೂ ಈ ಭೂಮಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯ ವನ ಮತ್ತು ಇತರ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯವನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಿಸುವಾಗ ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೂ, ಇಡೀ ಪೃಥ್ವಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೂ ಅವರವರ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಜೀವವನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಿಸುವಂತಹ, ಜೀವಂತವಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಜೀವಿತದ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಮಗೂ ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೂ ಸಹಾಯವಾಗುವಂತಹ ಆ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ನಮಗೆ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು. ಶಾಂತಿ, ಸಹನೆ, ಸಹಬಾಳ್ವೆ, ಈ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೃದ್ಧಿ ನಮಗೆ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್. ಮೈ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ಬಡಿ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಮೈ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದ ವನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವೇ ವಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ ದ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. Once again, I wish every one of you the best wishes of 78th Independence Day. The children, teachers, all those who have worked for this day, we have seen a very good performance from the children, especially the teachers and those who are responsible to prepare them, and also the parents who have brought your children here. Also given them a good practice. Congratulations to all of you. Let this continue unless this institution flourish in the same way. And also I request all of you to be with our children and to be with the institution. Thank you and may God bless you.
Thank you, Father, for inspiring message.
No matter what language you speak, a kind and smiling thank you always speaks to everyone's heart. May I now request Assistant School People Leader of Class 9 to express her words of gratitude.
Gratitude makes a sense to our past, brings peace for today and creates a vision for tomorrow. Good morning, one and all, present here. On behalf of St. Anne English Medium School, I deem it a great honor and privilege to express my deep sense of gratitude to all those who have made this day's program a befitting one. At the very outset, I extend a heartfelt thanks to our honorable correspondent, Reverend Father Sylvester DeCosta, the president of this program. Thank you, Father, for your laudable presence and constant support. On behalf of everyone present here, a big thanks to you, dear Father. I would like to express my deep sense of gratitude to our honorable chief guest, Mr. G. Throt, for being kind enough to accept our invitation, despite of his busy engagement on his specialized field. He has made time to grace this occasion. Thank you, sir, for helping the flag and enlightening us with your wonderful message. We are blessed to have with us St. Anne Parish Pastor, Committee Vice President, Mr. Santos DeCosta, Secretary, Mrs. Celine DiMello, elected members from Parish Council, Mr. Harold Montero, and all the management committee members who always stand by us. Thank you all for being a part of this celebration. We have with us the PTA Vice President, Mr. John Vinod Reko, and all the PTA Executive Committee members who respond quickly and cooperate with us at any time. We remain grateful to you all and extend a big thanks. I express my sincere gratitude to our headmaster, Mr. John Pais, who takes keen interest in all the activities of this institution. Thank you, sir, for planning and leading this event in a beautiful manner. I thank our primary headmistress, Mrs. Irene Menezes, and all the staff members for their hard work and cooperation to put up this program. Thank you all. I thank all our parents, guardians, well-wishers, and all those who have come to witness this program and be a part of this celebration. Thank you all for your support and graceful presence. I thank all my friends, students, for entertaining all of us by your amazing performance. You have really enhanced our joy. Especially, we thank Master Nelson and Ms. Lahari for conducting this program. Thank you all. We thank Mr. and Mrs. Reena DiMello, the management committee member, and Master Gayan from UKG for sponsoring sweets on his birthday. We wish Gayan a very happy birthday. May God bless you for your generosity. We would like to thank Mr. Lawrence DeSouza and his team for providing sound system and Mr. Lambert Alvarez for the videography of this event. We also thank Mr. Victor DeSouza for providing photography. A big thanks to you all. We thank the dance choreographer, Mr. G.P. Sir, for preparing the children of this celebration. A special thanks to all those who supported us in one way or the other to make this program a memorable one. Thank you all. Once again, I thank each one of you for your graceful presence. Thank you one and all. Wishing you a very happy 78th Independence Day. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Lord Almighty, for allowing us to present this program and preventing the rains from taking place now. Thanks, glory to you.
With this, we have come to the end of today's program. On behalf of St. Anne English Medium School, wish you all a happy Independence Day. Now, let's pause here, Mother India. Jai!